Good morning. Yes, I know there's many, many disparities happening, and I'd like to broach one subject at a time rather than being snowballed avalanche style by everything. You know, identification issues down to ethics, and how does the married woman get her half of the house property listed in her credit on her bank, because a lot of obvious there. That a lot of countries in the world, when we talk about group conglomeration, of taking that loan credit, all of the payments you have made towards a house is a loan credit that's yours. This new system is going to absolutely allow you that money. So that money would be in your balance as a credit towards the houses that you are listed with. Now, because it is a credit, that also, if you listed yourself as sole proprietor, yet you're married, that is a community property. So somehow we gotta give her half of that credit. So we have these types of database issues to deal with. And yeah, we know that this type of stuff goes on, and we don't want any of that leaving women in the lurch. Men or partnerships. Also, I also want to deal with partnership issues, because if you've been living with a person for 4 years, we'll say. And you both have been pretty much married, and you know, putting your monies together into a purchase. We have to absolutely figure out those little details. So it does get a little gritty there. And I didn't want to talk about that, actually, darn it. Because that's a one issue. That's a one issue topic, isn't it? And if I go down the trail of, because I want to talk about another thing. I want to talk about the cooperative business of a wine region. And I think that's taking. Now I'm going from property to business, and it's all business, isn't it? At the end of the day, you own a property. You own more than one property. It becomes a business, doesn't it? It's like, oh my gosh, the business of ownership, isn't it? The business of ownership. And then I'm like, well, how am I even helping any of you right now today? I'm not. All right. I will go with, because I have three business models. I know I've only listed two on my blog, but I actually have three. I have the original, which is the cooperative business ownership take, where every human being in that business, we will take a building supply center. Everyone, including the person who rings the machine, and the person who places orders, every single human being, even the main manager of the business, everyone gets paid the same amount. We're all getting paid this 44. So you're already prepaid. With every business, everybody. Now, because you're already prepaid, that's not anything out of anything. But with this type of business, to support it, you would each give perhaps $1,000 of your prepayment money into the business, not to work there, but on the premise that business makes an earning. So you have, I hate to do the math fast, but you have a building supply center that is a huge conglomerate. Each one of those people, 10,000 of them, put in 1,000 from their prepaid 44. That 1,000 grouping from the prepaid 44 every year, what is it? Does anybody know that math really quick? It adds up. It tallies, okay? Now, because I think it goes to 10 million. So it may be 10 million input to that company every year. But that's for supplies, that's to run the company, that's for everything. Now, hopefully, that company makes its little nominal earnings, because there is a markup. Everybody loves those. We have to have that, because they went to work. They have to be paid for that effort. They went to work. They actually put on those funny little suit clothes. And, yeah, they are strange, aren't they? And so for that, they get paid perhaps a little 30% markup off of their 1,000. So they might come back and have 300. I know it's not a lot, but each one of them may have 300 as an earning. Now, that's the only way you're going to earn with this system. We are not talking about major earnings, but that particular business, because it has 10,000, everyone, even the head leader of the company, only gets the 300. That is an exact fair pyramid system. Now, that leader is chosen by every single human being within the business. So they are risen to that leadership role, and that's all they do. They work the leadership roles, and there's, yes, back to the 21 days only. So, because this is not a work until you die system. So you will need several leaders. You'll need probably 17 leaders a year to run that company. So there you go. You can still have that head honcho, but you'll need 17 of them, and they will only show up for 21 days. Like you, Mr. and Mrs. Teller woman, who are at the cash register, you only show up for the 17. So it does have that equation. It's an absolutely equal cooperative. So that does work. And you have the 300, and that goes into your savings, your in-stasis savings account. And that type of a savings account is a buildup that you can use towards spendings on a property if you want to go down that trail, or a luxury item without a loan. So anyway, I think I have to stop there. Yeah, that's the pyramid model with a completely equal status. And if you already own that pyramid, let's say you already own all those building supplies, stores, and centers, chances are you really already have, you remember you're getting the 44, you already have loans up the wazoo anyway, and you already have so many properties that we don't even want to talk to you, so it doesn't matter. Those will still be listed in your portfolio. You will still have your properties. So don't worry about a thing, and you will still have your luxury items. They will not be seized out of your garage. We are not going to take your Rolls Royces away. So whatever you are left with right now, Van Gogh, whatever Monet is hanging upon your dining room overboards there, you get to keep them because you've made your riches to this point in time. But in eloquence of the future of those riches, you get your 300 a year. You get your 44 and your 300 a year. That's fair. And you get the notoriety of being the head honcho of that company. So there is that. You get your expertise notoriety. So you may be asked to do interviews on the news. Thank you. That's all I have to say.